want to magnify you together this morning. I pray you'll touch every person in this room tonight. God, let us leave differently when we came through those doors. And we give you thanks for it in Jesus' name. Everybody shout it out.
Thank you. meeting, I mean, ladies' Bible study and prayer meeting. It's at 5:30, and so don't forget that. Tuesday night, I want to get this, ladies, hear me real close, okay? Tuesday night, we're hosting, our church is hosting a Deborah's Voice, and it's those ladies are going to Washington. If you're not going to Washington, I want you still yet at this meeting. We're going to have fellowship. It's a lot of different churches going to be there. And we're hosting it, so I don't want just me to be there. Come on. Say amen, Barbie. I need some women there. So I ask you to be there at 6 o'clock. We're having food. That usually does it. We're having food. So don't forget, ladies, 6 o'clock Tuesday night, I need you to be there. And it won't last that long. They usually don't. And so I ask you to come. And if they do, so what? Glory, the Lord shows up, we're going to go with it anyway. So that's at 6 o'clock Tuesday night. Wednesday night at 6:30, we have church. And this Wednesday night, Sister Reba Casey is going to be with us, and she's going to be preaching. This Wednesday night, 6:30, all the way from Louisville, Kentucky. And you don't know her, a lot of people do. She's a fireball. So expect to hear a word from the Lord. And so be sure and be here. Thursday night, Bible study at 6:30 right here at the church. And it's for everyone. So I think that's all I've got going this week. Is it, David? Usually, help me.
Is there Blessed Mamas on Thursday night?
Blessed Mamas on Thursday night?
Yeah.
This Thursday night? Blessed Mamas up at the fellowship hall, right?
Yeah.
At
6:30.
So don't forget that. A lot of things going on. So get involved in it and be there. And so don't forget all of these announcements and remember that. Also, I guess we want the brothers to come.
I have a couple of announcements.
Oh,
today we'll be having drama practice at 4:30. So those of you that are involved in drama, or anybody that wants to be involved in drama, be out here today at 4:30. We will be having youth service at 6 o'clock this evening.
So don't forget that. Remember that. All right, let's stand and do our declaration this morning. As we bring in today's tithes, offerings, and over and above giving, we are believing the Lord for a supernatural release of God's favor over every area of our lives, jobs and better jobs, checks in the mail, inheritances, secure investments, scholarships, creative ideas, finding money, healing for our spirit, soul, and body, deliverance to the captive, salvation to the lost, and an outpouring of the Holy Ghost. We are blessed, and we will be a blessing to others in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Give him a hand. Before I give this to Daniel this morning, you know we've missed some services, so I'm asking you to dig just a little bit deeper today. And we don't stand here and ask for money or do that. But I'm just telling you, God will bless you for it. That's all you need to know.
As I was reading the book of Job this week, it was a book of verses that just kind of jumped out. In Job chapter 9, verse 32, it said, "For he is not a man that I am," talking about God, "that I should answer him, or we should come together in judgment. Neither is there any danger betwixt us, that might lay his hand upon us both. Let him take his rod away from me, and let not his fear terrify me. Then would I speak and not fear him, but it is not so with me." Now, and that's in the King James Version, but out of the NLT Version, that's the one I would read. It says, "God is not mortal like me, so I cannot argue with him or take him to crown. But if only there was a mediator between us." That's Jesus Christ. Said, "But if only there was a mediator between us. and sit at the right hand of the Lord, take an intercession for us. I think in John chapter 1, whenever the sons of God came before God, and Satan came along with them, you know, Satan was the accuser of the brother. He was accusing us. You know, if Jesus Christ had been sitting there at that time, he said, just get on out of here. He's covered. You know, he's covered by the blood, you know. But that mediator, that just, you know, that mediator is in there to stand there between us and take a hold of both of us. And it, the virgin said, just gotta take my hand and take God's hand and just bring us back together. You know, that's the reason God sent Jesus here.
Yeah.
To be that mediator.
Amen.
You may go to work with us more.
Remember Reverend Brock and Merle's mom, they had to put her in the hospital last time.
Yeah.
know what the Lord will say today is if you're here and you don't know Him, you can find this friend called Jesus. He's a merciful God. He's a God of forgiving. He don't bring up your past. People may bring your past up, but Jesus will never bring your past up. He loves you just the way you are. He don't want you any different. He don't want you to be like me. He don't want you to be like nobody else. He wants you to be you. And He wants you to come just as you are. Well, I need to maybe get some things straightened out here before I come to the altar. The Lord said, today is your day. You don't have to wait any longer. You don't have to wait to get things straightened out. But the Lord said, I will forgive you as you walk up out of that pew and you come to this altar. This is your day. And I, the Lord, will forgive you. Sometimes it's so hard for people to forgive. And there's people that sits on the church pews with forgiveness in their heart. And they think they're going to heaven. But let me tell you something. My word says, if you don't have forgiveness in your heart, you're not going to make it through the gates.
Oh,
oh
yeah. True.
Yeah, but this is doing this one and this is doing that one. It don't matter what they're doing. It's what Jesus says. You hear me? It's what Jesus says. Today, I don't have to stand before Michael and give an account of what I've done. But I have to stand before an Almighty God that went to a cross and died on a cross for me. And let me tell you something. He is a forgiving God, and He will forgive you. And this morning, you're sitting here, and you said, but you don't know what all I've been through. You don't know what all I've done. Well, I want to tell you something. Jesus knows. And His love reaches so far. So far, I'm telling you. He's a loving God. We want to look and think, you know, He's a God that will chastise. He does. He does do that. I'm not going to stand up here and say, you just live any way you want to and go to heaven. No, you can't. You have to have a holy life before Him. And what does that mean? You need to sacrifice. You give yourself to the Lord and you give everything to Him and you say, here I am, Lord. I give it to you. And then, this is what repentance means. You're walking this way. You're going down the sinful path. And all at once, you make a complete U-turn and you go the other direction and you're saying, I'm not doing those things back there anymore and I'm walking with the Lord. That's what it means. So this morning I ask you, are you ready to meet the Lord? I ask you sitting in these pews that may have been saved for a while. Are you ready to meet the Lord? Are you ready if He should call today? Are you ready?
Come on, tell us.
Do you have everything under the blood? Ooh, that blood applied to your heart. Ooh, when the devil sees that since you had a talk with the Lord. Have you went all week and not have a talk with the Lord? Have you been? Well, it's been about, I don't know, and I don't understand how them people are shouting. They're feeling all that, and I can't feel a thing. When's the last time you talked to the Lord? When's the last time you had a relationship with Him? When's the last time you picked up this word and you begin to read what He says about you?
Come on.
Sometimes we go through things because we allow it.
That's right.
The poor old devil, we put the blame on him for everything. Well, you know that devil. Well, you know that flesh too. That flesh. You have to look and see. You got to get that flesh under subjection. You hear me? You got to get that flesh under subjection. And that's not easy to do sometimes. You hear me? You got to do that. It's not easy. But if you listen, if you get in the Word and you begin to pray and you begin to seek the Lord, you'll find out your attitude will change. Your attitude won't be the same. You'll find you're loving people that you thought you didn't love. You hear me? And you begin to look and say, Lord, what has happened to me? It's because you found a fellowship with the Lord. You found true fellowship. And that true fellowship is with me and the Lord. Woo! Have mercy. Have mercy. I got a sermon to preach. I may preach it next Sunday. I don't know when I'll preach it. But I got the stuff ready. Some of you is going to get wet today. Some of you did get wet today. You got your feet in the river. Hear me? You come out and you got your feet in the river. But what happens next? You got your feet in, but this part from all the way up's got to get in. Huh? Am I telling you the truth? You got to get all of this in. You can't just get your feet in and just wall around in the mud like Michael would say he did. When them boys walked throwing in, am I right? Or was it that? Michael can't swim, no. Don't throw him in. I'll lose him. But around the edge, there's just mud. And all this junk. And that's what you stir up. You stir it all up. But when you get out into the deep, and you begin to see that, this morning we're going to have an altar service. and this is your day. Remember when Jesus went and Zacchaeus was up in the tree? He was standing up there, he ran on ahead because he wanted to get a better glimpse of the Lord. Jesus said, come on down. Come out of that tree. I'm going to your house today. Woo! Ho! Today he's coming home with you. He wants to go to your house today. He wants to partake with you today. He wants to know you today. Are you ready to surrender everything to him? Oh, my Lord. Let's stand this morning. Let's stand. As she sings this song this morning, I want you. And you may be sitting here today and you may say, well, I feel like I've got everything all right before, but I'm not 100%. If you're not 100%, please come and let us pray with you. Let us see that it's 100%. That's right, they say. Tell them, baby, God. Just a matter of
about something that happened to me the other day. I've got a friend on the beach, on, good friend, well, excuse me. But I've heard him make a statement several times, and he made it to me, and I knew where he was coming from. He's trying not to be a hypocrite. And believe you me, he's not. But I've heard him say a couple of times, I'm not going to be no Christian or nothing. And then something just flew up in me. I said, why don't you quit saying that? I knew him, I knew where he was coming from. I knew he was very capable of knocking more knots on your head than you could run them, you know. But I said, why don't you quit saying that, bud? You know, I love him. I said, you're right. And we right. And I'm trying to explain to him what Romans 10 talks about when it says confession is made to salvation. Wow. How important that is for us to say the right thing. And I understood that he was trying not to be a hypocrite. I said, I want you to stop saying, I ain't no Christian, or don't claim you're no Christian, but I want you to start saying, I'm a believer. You can say that without being a hypocrite. How many of you believe in God?
Yeah.
You can say, I believe in God. How many of you believe that God sent his only Son?
Yes.
You can say that. How many of you believe that Jesus is your only hope, whether you can say it
or
not? See, you can say without being hypocritical, without telling a lie, I'm a believer. And as that confession gets stronger and stronger, something begins to happen inside of you. Hope, buddy. I want you to quit saying that stuff about being a Christian.
Yeah.
Now, the Lord only knows what he's been into since then. But the other day he called me on the phone. I said, you still a believer? He said, I sure am. Yeah. Something began to click in. You know, I think everybody in this place ought to have the opportunity to say that this morning.
Right. Yeah.
And I want the whole church, if you don't mind, stand with me and let's all of us pray a prayer of forgiveness or of repentance, and when we're through, we're going to say what we believe. That doesn't mean that you've got everything straightened out in your life and that there's not room to grow, but if you're honest and sincere, I believe you'd go out of here with something that had changed your life. Would you just pray after me? Oh God, have mercy on me, a sinner. I believe Jesus came to die in my place.
I believe Jesus came to die in my place.
That he is the only hope of humanity.
That he is the only hope of humanity.
He is my only hope.
He is my only hope.
Please forgive me, Jesus.
Please forgive me, Jesus.
Come into my life.
Come into my life.
And give me salvation.
And give me salvation.
And home in heaven.
And home in heaven.
When this life is over. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, would you say, I'm a believer?
I'm a believer.
I believe in God.
I believe in God.
I believe in Jesus Christ.
I believe in Jesus Christ.
I believe he came to take away my sin.
I believe he came to take
away my sin. And I glorify him for that.
And I glorify him for that.
And I ask his Holy Spirit to live, to cause me to live in a pleasing way.
God's good. He's a great, great, mighty God. And I thank him. I thank him for what he's doing in this church. I give him praise for what he's doing in this church. I thank him for what he's going to do in this church. I give him praise because because healings are going to take place. I give you praise because the glory of the Lord is going to shine upon this church. I believe it beyond the shadow of a doubt. I believe it. And I'm telling you, I'm looking for God to do it. I'm looking for Him to do it. We have some birthdays today. Pat is 70 years old. Time is 70. Monday. Well, seriously. Alyssa had a birthday. She's not 70 though. So y'all want to stand up? Yes, she did. Sis had a birthday, but she's 1 year to be 70. Stand up. Michael, stand up. You ain't 70, are you?
Our Greg had a birthday.
Greg, get yourself up there. Gail had a birthday. She sure did. Stand up. I'm trying to read it. That's all right. We ain't been to church in 2 weeks. Brittany, get a birthday. Who else?
Emma.
Yes, sir.
Emma had a birthday. Daniel had a birthday. I was looking back there at Brian was going, I was like, Daniel or Betty, which one? Daniel has a birthday. We've got a lot of birthdays today. God's been good to you.
For God to opportunity to go up there and spend a week with her. They've only gave her 2 months at the most. But anyway, her daughter, we would see all the family at Christmas when and had Christmas with her. And I think they worked out all their differences and everything. And her daughter went with us when we went to spend the week. And her daughter stayed with her and is taking care of her. And I just thank God for answering that prayer. It was God that moved in that. And God has prayed for her. She's in real good spirits. You know, they said 2 months at the most, and she said, well, I knew it. And but she said, I'm not afraid to die. And but remember her and the family. And the last word she said when I left was, she said, who knows, I might be this. So, you know, all things are possible with God, so just pray for us.
I do just want to ask before we left this morning, if anyone gets saved today, if you give, raise your hand, because I want to miss without